Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, November 19th at 6 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee McClevitt?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Trustee Chavez, will you lead us in the pledge?
Yes, thank you, Mayor. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. We have one item on the agenda tonight. That's Resolution 141899, Resolution Authorizing an Agreement with Performance Institute LLC. Steve Golden, please.
Thank you, Mayor and Board. As you're aware, we've had a contract with Performance Institute for the past approximately year. We did two six-month contracts approximately with this group. We're recommending to continue our relationship one more contract. We have looked at a lot of different possibilities. We have looked at a lot of different ways to increase our economic development in markets that we don't currently spend a lot of time on. And this particular contract does do that. It looks at Asian markets for investment, for building opportunities, and for economic growth and development within Romeoville. This contract is a little bit more unique than the contract that you've seen in the past. This is a incentive laden contract that does pay a retainer of $6,000 per month, but is mostly incentive based. Their current rates, they charge clients anywhere from $100 to $225 an hour. They have a client in Chicago that's $225, and they have municipal clients in other states that are $100 and $125 an hour. This particular contract, based on 20 hours a week, is roughly $65 an hour, which is below the market rate. However, the incentive portion is in there to make up that difference. It is our hope that the relationships that have been created over the past 6 months, eight to 12 months, create helps us establish that relationship with the foreign markets and it creates economic development with Romeoville. Very tough recommendation, but I think it's something we need to look at. A lot of discussions with the mayor to see if this is something we want to do again. There has been some possibilities out there, and this is kind of one of the things that, and Dawn and I had a lot of discussions on this. This is kind of one of the things that, if you kind of damned if you do it sometimes and damned if you don't, you know, because you might leave something on the table. But because we've created a lot of relationships out there, we don't want to leave anything on the table. And so we'll give it one more shot, is what my recommendation is.
Very good. A couple of quick things I'll add to it as well. Again, for the folks at home watching this, again, the consulting firm that we've had for a short period of time already, initially was reshoring of manufacturing, we've now broadened the scope in large degree to also kind of include in a lot of discussions we've had is also then foreign investors into as equity investors in various types of projects, everything from housing to retail to commercial, a multitude of opportunities that exist with some of these larger investors looking to make U.S. investments. So in that regard as well, we've kind of broadened that scope to have a kind of a bigger umbrella on opportunities to bring those foreign investments. And again, this is to bring foreign investment back into our, and foreign dollars back into our community on a wide range of opportunities from everything from manufacturing, like I said, through equity investment opportunities for a wide range of development projects, which is continues to be a tough thing in our marketplace as the economy has continued to slowly come back. One of the things that's still difficult out there are equity investors for a lot of these projects that and the banks require larger private investment. So if there are opportunities and we can bring some of those opportunities into our community, it's something that we've added to the scope of work and more narrowly focusing. And again, setting some performance performance measure opportunities so that we're trying to move this along as quickly as we can, knowing that it does take a little bit of time to develop this kind of program. And I think it's good opportunity to do it for at least next year, and then we'll reevaluate at that point and see where we're at. It's a good group. They brought in a lot of excellent prospects already that we've had good conversations with, but as it does take a little time, but worth the investment to try and give them the opportunity for at least the term of this next contract for another year. We're one of the few places in this area doing this, so it's aggressive on our part, but the payoff could be quite substantial if we're able to develop this kind of programming. So, you know, other entities that are out there that do this is like World Business Chicago. I mean, the types of entities that are out there that are competing, we're getting an excellent rate to create this type of opportunity, which I think is credit to the consulting firm that shows the belief they have in us as an entity to give us this type of superior rate compared to the other entities that they work with. So it shows what they believe in it as well. So and that's why I think we're one of the first ones to go to adding this performance measure, performance incentive, in order to balance out the cost versus the potential. So questions or comments? Trustee Chavez,
you're the most recent
visitor to the Asian continent.
Yes, I am. Yeah, and there's a lot of money out there, that's for sure. There's, you know, obviously they have grown quite a bit, and their cost of living has gone up, so they're actually looking to move out to invest back in the States. I mean, they just read an article today through work, you know, they've gone up 30% in the past 5 years compared to Laos and other Asian countries that are out there. But another thing I want to mention so the public understands too is that our EDC committee works with this group, you know, every day, every month, or whatever you want to call it. And a lot of the members on there are in support of this as well. So this isn't something that it's just us alone are pushing for or looking forward to. Our EDC members are business owners in town, but people who work for the school district participate in this EDC committee. And there are business owners also part of this committee. And what I gathered last, speaking to them all, you know, they're all very supportive of this, and they're all business owners and they understand how business works. So I think it's the right move to extend it one more year, and let's see what, you know, what we can gain out of this. So that's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Excuse me. I definitely like the idea of the incentives. It makes them more motivated to go out and actually get some work done. A couple questions I had, and I'll ask them first. You can answer them in whatever order. First of all, how do we measure the success of the Performance Institute? Is it just by more bites? Is it by actual investments? Is it by a certain amount of investments? So what are we using to measure to success? And then one of the parts of the agreement talks about expenses. Do we have clearly defined definition or whatever of what the expenses that we may reimburse for? For instance, as an example, if Sunny, I believe is the name of the person, has a meeting at 8 o'clock in the morning that lasts till 11. Food is part of that. Are we paying for breakfast? Are we paying for lunch? Are we paying for dinner? How does all that work?
Sure. Let me answer the first one. We have a saying in what does success look like? And, you know, anytime we measure or look at a program internally, we say, hey, what does success look like at the end of the day? To me, and I think success looks like, what type of foreign investment did they bring into Romeoville? Did it create jobs? Did it create a greater tax base? Did it create economic development for our community? So I think that's how we measure their success. And as Trustee Chavez will tell, the culture, the Asian culture, especially with the Chinese money that we're looking at or the investment that we're looking at, it takes a long time to create those relationships. That's just the way their culture works, and it's not like here in the United States where you and I can sit down and, okay, we have a deal in 2 days, versus it might take 2 years for a deal to be commenced because of a relationship that has to be built. And it gets vetted through many levels in the Chinese hierarchy. And so what has happened is that those relationships have been forged over the past 6 or 8 months. And so we're hoping we're to a level now that we can start seeing the success of economic growth and seeing the success of increased tax base in the development, and so we can now measure that. That's the goal. Will it happen, as the mayor's, you know, will it happen? You know, and that's why this is a tough recommendation. As I said, there's no guarantees that we're going to have a $20 million or a $5 million or a $100 million project. There is no guarantees. All we can guarantee is that they and we will work hard to make sure that that success is achieved. Second, answer your second question, expenses. The contract, Rich had put in there in the contract that if any expenses such as meal reimbursement or meetings or if she's going to fly to China on behalf, has to be approved by me. So if it's a $5 meal expense, no big deal. If she is saying that I'm going to meet with the Chinese consulate in New York on behalf of Romeoville, I'm going to say, well, you know, no, that's not part of it right now. We're not going to reimburse you. We can do that through Skype, or we can do that through some other means, versus you flying to New York. Or, hey, Steve, I think we can get a deal here or whatever. New York is really, really important. I'm just using hypotheticals. Then I would have the autonomy saying, yeah, okay, maybe this might be a good idea. We'll then go ahead and, but I have the final approval to say yes or no on expense reimbursement.
Thank you. I appreciate hearing that, too. Excuse me. I have a frog this evening. I appreciate hearing that, too, because the devil's in the details. Not only that, in some agreements, one party might think they have one position, another party has another position. We're trying to build relationships. We don't want small details to create issues there. So I like to hear that, you know, it has to be approved through you first, and I think that's the best way to go.
Correct. And then we determine collectively, I'll talk to the mayor and the board and say, hey, this is a big expenditure that's not, you know, that's in here, but here is the pros and cons, and here this could be a really positive result, or yeah, it's not something that we think that could be. And so that gives us the flexibility to say yes or no. Yes.
Very good. Any other questions or comments? Trustee Chavez.
Yeah, a little bit more. Steve, just so everybody's residents were too, you know, they've actually brought Asian investors out here already. Mm-hmm. It's not like we haven't been working on this in the past. And I believe Steve and you, Rockwell, sat down with them, and you actually received a booklet with information on these companies and who these investors are and stuff. So it's, you know, this isn't, we're just starting out. This has been in process now for a while.
You're absolutely correct.
I just want the residents to understand that. They've had Chinese investors come out long ago. They toured the village already. They've seen our assets. They've seen our infrastructure. They see what's here. And they still want to participate. So the communications can just continue.
Right. And the key for that is they're not the decision makers. So now they have to go to the next level within the Chinese government, and the next level, and the next level, to get to where they're comfortable with Romeoville, and they're comfortable with investment. So it's first impressions are lasting, right? So we have to make sure we have a good first impression so that they take it back to their people who create that relationship building, who then ultimately creates the economic development.
Very good. Well, again, we've talked about this at length, and again, I think the opportunity to give it to, you know, at least through this next contract term, we'll evaluate throughout, and that's why we've moved to a more performance-based type of incentive program for them. And it, like I said, we're one of the first to do that. We've got a now lower rate than most of their clients, and we'll be pushing them for that. We'll give them this opportunity, and we'll see where we'll evaluate from there. So, very good. Anything, any other questions or comments? Well, hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Palmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitt?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We'll move straight into the regular meeting of the Village of Romeoville this Wednesday, November 19th, 2014, at 6:15 p.m. May I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee McClevitt?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Chavez, will you lead us in the pledge?
Yes, thank you. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Petitions from the public? Chris?
Makes it easy that it's just me. So my name is Chris Brush, and I live at 42 Abbeywood Drive in Romeoville, and I'm here on behalf of the Harvest Saturday Food Drive, which is this Saturday, November 22nd. And this is the 21st annual Northern Will County Harvest Saturday Food Drive. And I know many of you have participated over the years, whether you're helping out on us out on that day or you're helping us with fundraising before that. So we do appreciate your efforts, the mayor and board of trustees, as well as all of our residents. And we've had a lot of new businesses contact us this year and actually coordinated their own food drives internally. And they'll be bringing over their food drive donation, their food donations to us Friday night and Saturday morning to get us started. So by the time things actually get rolling around 11 o'clock, we should have food, a lot of food already ready to be sorted and start moving that whole chain of processing. So the volunteers will be going house to house to pick up food or monetary donations that are delivered 100% to the community food pantries. The overhead that we have, you know, there's hot dogs that we actually provide to the volunteers, hot chocolate, that kind of stuff. But those funds were already raised through our couple of fundraisers at At's a Nice Pizza in Culver's. So we've been really fortunate this year, and people have been extremely generous. So thank you all for that. Some of the churches, I want to make sure that everybody understands this is not a religious event. It is a community event. It's important that some of the churches take a lead role in sponsoring this, but it's not the churches that this benefits. It's really the people of Romeoville, the people of the Romeoville community that this benefits. And at what better time of year than Thanksgiving can we provide benefits to those people who are hungry and are in need than to do this? So St. Andrew the Apostle Catholic Church, Community Christian Church, United Presbyterian Church, and The Rock Church. So we thank them all. Residents may leave their bags of non-perishable food items on their front porch with a note marked Harvest Saturday. They may also drop off non-perishable food donations at one of our four drop-off locations until Friday at 5 p.m. That's the Village Hall, Romeoville Rec Center on Romeo Road, Fire Station 1 on Montrose Drive, and Fire Station 3 on Birch Lane. Our collection center is again at St. Andrew the Apostle Church and School at 505 Kingston Avenue in Romeoville. So in case there's any last minute volunteers who want to take advantage of the 40 degree balmy weather that we'll have on Saturday, God willing it'll be sunny, can come by and volunteer their time. Even we need people who sit and fold up the plastic bags that all this food comes, you name it, we have volunteers for everything. Unloading the cars, getting shopping carts around. They say it's organized chaos. I think it's beyond organized chaos. It's that nobody has ever hurt, God willing, nobody's ever, but it's just a blessing. It's truly just unbelievable that the whole event comes off as well as it does. We usually have over 500 volunteers and thousands of boxes of food that actually goes out to the pantry, in addition to the food or the monetary donations. I think last year we were able to distribute over $1,800 to the different food pantries. So it's an overwhelming community event. So thank you all for allowing us to take part and for your participation as well. Any questions, or you're all good?
No, but I do want to once again thank you. I couldn't put it better than what Chris just said. It this really is a community event. But I do want to thank all the faith-based groups and churches that are involved, because without them we couldn't do this. And they're very special to our community. But for this is about helping your neighbors, and it's just a wonderful group of people that put it together from their hearts and from their spirits, and have been doing it for a long time. And we've lost some wonderful folks that weren't with us anymore that we will always remember, that have helped us get us here. But we're going to carry on the spirit well into the future, and continue to remember all that good work, and do good work and, well, for all of our neighbors into the, as we go forward. And as Chris mentioned, and if you see one of their flyers that are around, on the back, and for those monetary donations, you can make them, and St. Andrews processes it, but they're just the processing entity. But you can make checks out to St. Andrew Harvest Saturday, 530 Glen Avenue, Romeoville, Illinois, 60446. I'm going to be writing a check and sending it over to help out, as always. And I encourage anyone else that has the means to step up. If you don't have food to put out, dig deep a little bit. Send over a check if you can't put it out to the volunteers on Saturday. And this really is easily our single largest volunteer opportunity of the entire year. If you can drive a car, they need drivers, always need drivers. Come on out. It's a wonderful experience to be a part of, and I'm sure everybody will realize you'll walk away feeling even better about not only yourself, but where you live and the spirit in your own community. So please be a part of it. Anyone else? Very good.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Next, do we have a consent agenda?
So moved.
Motion for consent agenda by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Pallminer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Pallminer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. Within that consent agenda, we have approval of minutes November 5th, workshop meeting, 2014 workshop meeting, approval of minutes November 5th, 2014 regular meeting, approval of bill schedule A, B, C, and D, and resolution 141900, resolution approving a final plat of re-subdivision for Uptown Square. So motion?
So moved.
Section approved by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Pallminer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
All right, Mayor's report. I'm going to try and keep this as quick as I can. I want to thank everybody who came out to the costume ball. It was a great turnout. Everybody had a wonderful time. Always for a good cause. And thank you to all those volunteers and committee members that took part and all the staff that helped out on that. We thank everybody who came out Veterans Day. We got it in. We got it inside. We pulled it off. Nothing was going to stop us that day. We were still going to get it done. So we still had a great crowd. I want to thank second grade classes at RC Hill School for letting me come over for career week yesterday. It was a wonderful crowd, lots of good questions. So we also want to congratulate PT Solutions on their ribbon cutting yesterday. And also Lieutenant School will be hosting their parent networking night tomorrow from 6 to 7. Harvest Saturday once again this Saturday. Dunkin' Donuts will hope, I know a lot of people have been asking about this one, but they're already open, but Dunkin' Donuts will have their official ribbon cutting on December 1st at 4:30, and I'm sure we'll be announcing Chipotle not too long after. Also, join us for the Winter Wonderland and tree lighting ceremony on December 5th at 6 p.m. at the Rec Center. SAC's Ladies Auxiliary will be hosting their annual toy raffle fundraiser on December 12th at Lost Acres. What's the start time on that, guys? 6, I think.
Six.
Yeah. Well, they'll be there in the evening. So, and they're always looking for donations as well. You know, buy a couple of gift cards, $10, $20. Throw them in for the raffles. It's always appreciated. It goes to a good cause. Congratulations to all the students who will be graduating from DARE program throughout the month of December. And once again, our office will be closed December 27th and 28th in observance of Thanksgiving. And with that, I want to wish everybody a happy and very safe Thanksgiving holiday. And we'll see you all when we come back in December. Clerk's report, please.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. I only like to wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving and a very safe holiday. That's it.
Thank you. We're gonna skip over committee reports for the till the next meeting. Village manager report.
Just two quick things, Mayor and Board. We'll be putting up our warming shelter information on the webpage in case obviously there's cool weather coming in awful early, so residents can contact our fire department and we can place you into a warming shelter if you do have issues with your heat. And then the last thing is just wishing the mayor and board and residents a happy Thanksgiving.
Very good.
Thank you.
New business, Resolution 141899, resolution authorizing agreement with Performance Institute LLC.
So moved.
Motion to approve by Trustee Chavez, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Palmer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
And Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. Board comments. We're going to start with Trustee McClevitz tonight.
Catch me off guard there, huh?
Uh-huh. Well, you know, Trustee Chavez took like three meetings worth last time.
Very good.
We love him. He was gone for a while, so we had
Thank
to catch
you,
up
Mr.
a
Mayor.
Little.
Thank you. First thing, I did want to mention, the mayor already spoke a little bit about the Youth Outreach Commission Costume Ball. They did raise $2,752 this year, which is about $350 more than they raised last year. So it was, again, a very successful event that continues to grow, and we're already looking forward to that for next year. The Harvest Food Drive was already mentioned, and I'm sure it'll be mentioned again, but that's coming up Saturday, November 22nd. Make sure to put that on your calendar. I just wanted to mention also the last day for yard waste pickup is the week of November 24th. I think it's important to know. Of course, I'm going to guess with all this wind, probably not too many leaves are left in anybody's yards to be raked up or not. But if you happen to have anything that you need to have yard waste picked up, that is the week of November 24th. The Winter Wonderland tree lighting ceremony and Christmas event is scheduled for Friday, December 5th. So that's right around the corner, already time for Christmas. That event is from 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock. Something they have new this year is a dueling pianos and iceless skating. So that sounds like very fun. And thanks to our recreation department folks that come up with creative new ideas all the time. Obviously, there's always the children's crafts, the inflatables, and just a ton of fun. Admission for the event is simply a can of food, and that is used to assist with the Hope for the Holiday care packages. Another event at the Recreation Department on Saturday, December 13th, is a sports card and collectibles show, and that's from 9 to 3. I just wanted to mention on a sad note, we have are very close with Tri-County SRA, and we had a young man, Matt Olson, who passed away just a short time ago. Very, very young. He was just in his late 20s. He lived right here in Romeoville, and I wanted to send my condolences out to his family. In speaking with the people at Tri-County SRA, Matt Olson was just had a smile that lit up the room. All the participants there and the staff there are certainly going to miss him. And again, I just wanted to send out my condolences to his family. Losing Matt at such a young age is certainly a tough thing for them. And then all I wanted to say at the end here is certainly happy Thanksgiving, happy and safe Thanksgiving to everybody. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. A couple of things. I was out of town and was unable to attend the Veterans Day ceremony, but I understand it went very well indoors and appreciate the hard work that everybody put in. I just wanted to take a moment to personally thank all the veterans that have served and are serving to keep us safe around the world. What an amazing job done by all. I'm going to promote, I did have the opportunity at the conference I was at to see a speaker. If you get a chance to read a book by Captain Scott O'Grady, Return with Honor, an amazing book. This is a gentleman that was shot down over Bosnia and talked to us for quite some time about his entire experience and really put a different spin on Veterans Day for us all. So an amazing man to hear him talk and how proud he was of serving our country and everything that he went through. So I just want to thank all the veterans out there. Ladies Auxiliary, the Hampton Park SAC Ladies Auxiliary fundraiser starts at 5:30 on Friday, December 12th. looked it up so we could make sure we got that time out there. That is down at Lost Acres. It's a good time, and the money goes to a good cause. So if you can go down there and help them out, they would greatly appreciate it. Harvest Saturday, it's going to be said a lot of times, but it is an amazing event. And it's one of those where, as Chris said, it's not a church event, but it is run by a majority of the faith-based communities, and that's because someone has to take control of it and charge of it and distribute that food. So thank you for doing that. But just to make sure everyone understands, the Marine Corps Junior ROTC from RHS will be there. In years past, I know the Girl Scouts have been there, because my daughter volunteered as a Girl Scout when she was young. There are many other community groups volunteering with this. It is truly the Village of Romeoville that does this. It really is, and the Village of Romeoville isn't us. It's all the people that live in town and are here every day, and they come out and they support their own, and they take care of their own, and it's a great thing to do at Thanksgiving. I hope everyone can either donate or volunteer in some way, because everyone should have at least a decent meal at Thanksgiving time. So hopefully we can see everyone out there. I will be there volunteering as always. Other than that, just everybody have a happy Thanksgiving and a safe Thanksgiving. That's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Clancy, please.
Thank you. I just wanted to make a special thanks to all the people that did get out for Veterans Day. With that terrible weather that we had, it was tremendous to show that you supported the veterans. And the comment that was going around that morning is, they're out in that weather, so why can't we thank them out in that weather? But I'm really glad that we did get in the firehouse, because it was nice. But Saturday, for Harvest Saturday, it's going to be a tremendous day, and like everyone else is saying, it's for the village. It's for everyone. It's not just certain groups. And you would not believe how many people get involved and how they help in such small ways. And one of the easy ways is you don't have to do anything at home. You just open your door, put your canned goods on the front step, and you're done. So we will be thanking you ahead of time and appreciate all that you can do for that. And then as far as the costume party that the others had made comment, it was just tremendous, and it was such a blast selling those tickets. So we got something to set forward to try to break the record for next year again, and it was just very entertaining. And the wingspan is the best way to buy your tickets. So I just wanted to let you know. So, and then one little thing, if you could, this is a little bit out of the different, but thanks, Mom and Dad. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mayor. Some of you may have read an article in Sunday's Tribune. It was a very disturbing article about some villages that have made some investments in some funds that have turned out very, very badly. And I, like I'm sure many of you, immediately thought, well, wow, are we involved in any of that? And I had a conversation with Kirk tonight, and I just want to let everybody know that we are not exposed in our village at all due to the good prudent management of the folks that make those decisions. So you have nothing to worry about that article. And as to the wingspan, you just have to find the biggest person in the room with the wingspan, not necessarily anybody's wingspan.
That's
and
right.
I just want to wish everybody a very happy Thanksgiving.
I'm sure our neighbors that got mentioned will appreciate that. I'll share your concern with them. Trustee Ballmer, please.
Thank you, Mayor. I too want to thank the staff that was able to move that veterans ceremony into that building. It's incredible how fast they got that done. And that was our own staff that took care of that and got it off in a pretty orderly fashion. I do appreciate that, and as well as everyone that attended. The costume ball was a great time. Some amazing costumes came out there. A lot of homemade things that were just incredible. Appreciated that. Harvest Saturday, I can't say enough. Please participate in any way that you can, whether it be monetary, whether it be things out of your own pantry that you want to give to families in need. If you can volunteer, volunteer, because there's never too many hands there, never. There's always something for somebody to do. You will not be idle for long, and just give whatever time you can. Other than that, happy Thanksgiving. Everyone be safe and enjoy your family. Thank you.
Trustee Chavez.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. For the residents that haven't noticed yet, Weber 95 has started. The interchange has started. They have some equipment down there already. It's gonna get a lot worse before it gets a lot better, so be patient or find another route when the real earth starts to move. So that's great that it's happening, but it's going to be an inconvenience for a while, so let's just be patient. Costume ball, I agree, it was awesome. And also, just want to mention the sack meat raffle that we had this past Sunday, and several trustees and the mayor was up there. You know, that's another organization that does great things for community. Everything they make, they give back to the youth programs. So I just want to say thanks to all those that participated both in the costume ball, both in the sack meat raffle, And here we are asking you to continue to support this community by attending Harvest Saturday. And I just want to confirm, we need to be there at 10 o'clock or 10:30?
10:45.
In the church?
10:30.
Don't be late. 10:30. Because we have a little prep up inside the church, right? A little prep thing.
Yes, short
service. Short service. Right. 10:30. So hopefully everybody can make it out for now. If you can make it for 2 hours, that's great, or an hour is even great. Just any amount you can give would be awesome. Also, I just want to mention the Winter Wonderland's coming December 12th, and that's always a great event. And I just want to say, you know, they'll have children's crafts, dueling pianos, inflatables, train rides, our tree lighting ceremony, and I want to just give a public thanks to Fat Ricky's for sponsoring it. There'll be some free pasta meals for the first 500 people that show up, and obviously we'll also have pictures with Santa there. The 5th, what did I say?
You said the 12th.
Oh, I'm sorry. 12-5. You get my numbers right. December 5th. Thank you, Dawn Caldwell. December 5th here at the Rec Center. Our tree lighting ceremony in Winter Wonderland. And with that, all I'd like to say is happy Thanksgiving to all, and safe one, please. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Well, with that, we don't have anything else. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin. Second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Palmer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClellan.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Have a wonderful Thanksgiving.